Hello everyone, it's Shannon here for Waffle Flower Crafts. In this video, we're going to do some no-line watercoloring using Tombow Dual Brush Pens. We're going to watercolor these flowers from the beautiful Bouquet Builder 7 set to create this very colorful and bold card. I'm going to start today's card with the Bouquet Builder 7 stamp set. I'm going to pull off some flowers and leaves from this set and position them here on an A2 panel of Bristol paper. Bristol paper is a very smooth paper and works really well for no-line watercoloring with Tombow Dual Brush Pens. After I position the stamps, I'm then going to ink them up in Ink on 3 ink and stamp them. As you can see, it's a very light ink and works really well for no-line watercoloring. Now my images are stamped, I'm now going to start watercoloring them. I have some water sprayed down onto my water media mat. I've also scribbled some 991 Tombow Dual Brush Pen ink down onto the mat too. I'm now mixing a small amount of water with the ink and I'm starting to paint the center of the flower, including the very center and all the stamen as well. Once I finish coloring those very lightly with that yellow, I'll move on to a darker yellow, which is 026, and start really adding in the fine lines of all those stamen. Now, it is difficult to see all the details from the impression. I'm just doing my best to kind of draw in those lines from those stamens. So it doesn't have to be absolutely perfect here, really just getting some of those little circles and lines just to kind of mimic that look of the center of the flower. After I finished those stamen, I'm now going to work in the very center, kind of work with that darker color to kind of create a gradation from the outer edge of the center, and then in the very center I'm going to make it a little bit darker. That kind of just breaks up that very open part of the center of the flower, and then I'll just blend that to make a nice gradation. Now that I finished with the center of the flower, I'm now going to move on to the petals. I'm using a really dark orange here, and I'm just going to start by kind of diluting it here and just painting the base for these petals. Painting this base layer goes pretty quick, and while I'm finishing this up, I want to point out that I add very little water to my Tombow Dual Brush Pens. I know this is called watercoloring, but I add just a small amount. I find that if there's too much water, you'll get some buckling of the paper and it really dilutes the color. So to keep it really intense, you add just a small amount of water. Now that I finished that base, I'm going in with that same orange and adding in my shadows. This is really making those petals pop and really adding that definition and that depth. I'm adding basically this darker shade anywhere at the base where the petal meets the center and anywhere where one petal overlaps another. And again, that just this little bit of adding that darker color really helps that flower and those petals to pop. Now that I've finished that poppy, I'm going to move on to another flower. Not sure if this is a peony or a rose, but for this flower I picked out a really rich mauve color, and I'm just going to start kind of at the base of the petal where the petal meets kind of the center, and I'm starting with my most intense color, and once I kind of lay that down, I'll then clean my brush and start to blend out that ink so it gets a nice gradation over the petal, and this will add a lots of depth and really start to make all these petals pop. Now this flower has a lot of petals, so this is a very time consuming process, but it is very repetitive, so I kind of skipped ahead here so you can kind of see me just repeat over and over again finding those petals. Again, some of the lines can be difficult to see because the ink is so light. Just do your best. It just doesn't have to be absolutely perfect. It is a flower, and you know there's not a set number of petals on this flower, so you don't have to stress so much about it. Just do the best you can to kind of see where the lines are and recreate these petals. I'm continuing to work my way around this flower. I am trying not to do two petals directly next to each other. Again, I am using only a small amount of water, so I don't have to worry too much about one petal kind of bleeding into the other, but it is good, just a good practice to kind of try to not do a petal right next to each other, kind of go back and forth. I kind of work on either side of the flower is kind of how I work. So now I'm going to move on to this really small flower here. I have a couple purples picked out. Start with my lighter purple and kind of just color the tips of this flower, and then I'll move to my darker purple and I'll color in kind of the center, starting from the center and then blending that color out so I get that darkest color down, and then I clean my brush a little bit and just with the tiniest amount of water kind of blend out that color. And I'm just going back and forth here, intensifying that darker shade, smoothing out the gradation, and then adding some of the veins back into the flower. Now that I've finished that purple flower, I'm now going to move on to my leaves. Now for these leaves, I'm going to do a combo of colors, starting with this really beautiful kind of blue-green color, just painting it really dark at the base of the leaf and the stem, and then once I get that dark color out, down. I'll then blend it out to create a nice gradation over the leaf. And then I'll move on to my other shade of green, which is 126. And then starting from the tip of the leaf, kind of blending towards the base of the leaf, I'll kind of add that green color. And that just really kind of warms it up and just adds a nice kind of a nice look with those two different shades. Now moving on to my other leaves. I always like to have two colors of greens for the leaves. And so this other set of leaves I have much more of an olive color. And I'm just simply coloring these just like I did with the petals, kind of the darker color at the base of the leaf and then blending it out. So I'm finishing up this kind of large, almost like branch of leaves. And now I'm going to do this little leaf here. I think this leaf is for the poppy. It's kind of fern-like. This one is has lots of details. So again, just do the best you can. Just taking my time here. I have a really thin brush and just kind of going over and trying to get all of those leaves. Again, I can't do it perfectly because it is a little bit hard to tell with the ink being so light, but I just do the best I can. So I'm just about done here, just finishing up the very tip of that leaf. And now I'm going to go back to my poppy here. I just felt like that orange just wasn't looking very good with my other flower colors. So I decided to kind of warm it up a little bit. So I have kind of a really like a red orange color, maybe a corally color. I'm going back over the petals again, just adding this other layer, this warmer color. And I think that will just kind of it just mixes better with the purples that I have already, that purple and mauve. So now that I finished coloring, I went ahead and die cut them out with the matching dies, and now I have an A2 panel of white cardstock, and I'm going to ink blend over this panel to create our background. I have several distress oxides picked out. I'm starting with ground espresso. That's going to go at the very bottom quarter of my panel. Then I'll move on to aged mahogany. I picked some really dark, deep, rich colors. I found that these darker shades really do help to make my no-line watercoloring flowers pop. I really like pairing my no-line watercoloring images with really rich, colorful backgrounds. So now that I've finished the aged mahogany, I'm going to move on to seedless preserves and ink blend this next portion of the panel. Again, going back over and blending with mixing kind of over the aged mahogany and even down at the bottom where the ground espresso is. I just wanted to kind of make this a little bit more mauvey and a little bit less kind of brown. Now that I've finished with the seedless preserves, I'm going to do a little picked raspberry. And once I do that top portion with the picked raspberry, I'll go back over with some more seedless preserves to just kind of smooth out that gradation. Now that I finished ink blending, I've grabbed a brush here. I've got it loaded with some water and I'm just adding some water spots. Like this will just kind of break up that background a little bit more and just add a little bit more interest to it. So I'm just going to continue to kind of splatter some of these water, these little water droplets all over. And because this is distress oxide, you get that beautiful kind of oxidation where the water droplets are. Now I have a little bit of Gonzai Tombi gold paint here. I'm going to do a little bit of splattering of this gold paint, kind of keeping it on the left side of the panel. I don't want any paint in the upper right because I want to keep that free for my sentiment. So now that the panel is completely dry, and I even heat set it a little bit, I went ahead and arranged my flowers, and they're not stuck yet. I just have them positioned there on the panel so I can figure out where I want my sentiment to go. The sentiment is from the Sweet Sentiment stamp set. Now that I've picked it up with my Misty, I'm going to pick up my flowers. I have a little piece of press and seal wrap, just going to press it all over that arrangement and put that to the side. I'm going to heat emboss my sentiment, so I did put down some anti-static powder. Now I'm going to ink it up in Versamark ink, pour on some gold embossing powder, and then just heat set with my heat tool. And again, I want to note that I did thoroughly dry this panel before I tried to do the embossing, because if this panel's wet at all, any of that ink blended background is wet, your embossing powder is going to stick to that instead of just where you stamped your sentiment. I went ahead and added some foam to the backside of my arrangement, removed the backing, and now I'm just going to place it here on the front of my panel. Once I get into the right spot, I'll then just peel the press and seal away, and that will complete my front panel. Now all I have to do is adhere this onto the front of an A2 top folding card base. So I'm just going to grab some liquid glue here, place it all over the front of my card base, and then stick down my panel. And I'll hold it just for a second to let that glue set up. And once that glue is set, this card is done. I'll hold it to the camera so you can get a good look. I had so much fun watercoloring these flowers and leaves from the Bouquet 7 stamp set and pairing them with a really bold ink-blended background, and the water spots I think add a beautiful atmospheric effect, and then the little hint of gold from the splatters and the sentiment I think just brings the whole card together. I hope you guys enjoyed today's card and video. If you'd like any more information on the products I use, please head over to Waffle Flower, and you can follow us on YouTube, Instagram, and Facebook for more creative ideas. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful day!